In this question, we have to evaluate each of the following using binomial theorem. First, let us begin with 96 cube. Here we will express 96 as sum or difference of two numbers whose powers are easier to calculate, and then we will use binomial theorem. That is, here we can write 96 as 100 minus 4. This implies 96 cube is equal to 100 minus 4 whole cube. Now by using binomial theorem, we have the expansion for x minus y whole raised to the power of n equals to nc0 x raised to n minus nc1 x raised to n minus 1 into y plus nc2 x raised to n minus 2 into y square all the way up to minus 1 ncn y raised to n. Now we will substitute x equals to 100, y equals to 4 and n equals to 3 to get the expansion of 100 minus 4 whole cube. So here we have 100 minus 4 whole cube is equal to 3c0 100 cube minus 3c1 100 square into 4 plus 3c2 100 into 4 square minus 3c3 into 4 cube. This is equal to 3c0 is 1 into 100 cube is 10 raised to the power of 6 minus 3c1 is 3 into 4 into 100 square is 10 raised to the power of 4 plus 3c2 is 3 into 4 square is 16 into 100 minus 3c3 is 1 into 4 cube is 64, which gives us 10 to the power of 6 is equal to 10 lakh, that is 1 followed by 6 zeros, minus 3 into 4 into 10 to the power of 4 is equal to 1 lakh 20,000 plus 16 threes are 48, 48 into 100 is 4800 minus 64 into 1 is 64, and when you do the arithmetic in this step you'll get 8 lakh 84,736. Hence we can say that 96 cube is 8,84,736. Next we have to evaluate 102 raised to the power of 5. Here we can write 102 as 100 plus 2. This implies 102 raised to the power of 5 equals to 100 plus 2 whole raised to the power of 5. And now using binomial theorem, we have the expansion for x plus y raised to the power of n equals to nc0 x raised to the power of n plus nc1 x raised to the power of n minus 1 into y plus nc2 x raised to the power of n minus 2 into y square and so on up to ncn y raised to the power of n. On substituting x equals to 100, y equals to 2 and n equals to 5 in this expansion, you'll get the expansion for 100 plus 2 whole raised to the power of 5. So here we have 100 plus 2 whole raised to the power of 5 equals to 5c0 into 100 raised to the power of 5 plus 5c1 into 100 to the power of 4 into 2 plus 5c2 into 100 cube into 2 square plus 5c3 into 100 square into 2 cube plus 5c4 into 100 into 2 to the power of 4 plus 5c5 into 2 to the power of 5. This gives us 5c0 is 1 into 100 to the power 5 is 10 raised to the power 10 plus 5c1 is 5 into 2 into 100 to the power 4 is 10 raised to the power of 8 plus 5c2 is 10 into 2 square is 4 into 100 cube is 10 raised to the power of 6 plus 5c3 is 10 into 2 cube is 8 into 100 square is 10 raised to the power of 4 plus 5c4 is 5 into 2 to the power of 4 is 16 into 100 plus 5c5 is 1 into 2 raised to 5 is 32. And now we can write 10 raised to the power of 10 as 1 followed by 10 zeros 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 plus 5 twos are 10 and 8 zeros for 10 to the power of 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, plus 10 into 4 is 40 into 6 zeros for 10 to the power of 6, plus 10 8s are 80 and 4 zeros for 10 to the power of 4, plus 16 into 5 is 80 and 2 zeros for 100, plus 32. And when you add all these terms, you'll end up getting 110408080 32. So this is the value of 102 to the power of 5. Next, we have to evaluate 101 to the power of 4. Here we can write 101 as 100 plus 1. This implies 101 to the power 4 is equal to 100 plus 1 whole raised to the power of 4. Now, by using binomial theorem, we can find the expansion for this quantity. 100 plus 1 whole raised to the power of 4 equals to 4c0 100 to the power 4 plus 4c1 100 cube into 1 plus 4c2 into 100 square into 1 square plus 4c3 into 100 into 1 cube plus 4c4 into 1 to the power of 4. This is equal to 4c0 is 1 into 100 to the power of 4 is equal to 10 raised to the power of 8 plus 4c1 is 4 into 100 cube is 10 to the power of 6 plus 4c2 is 6 into 100 square is 10 to the power of 4 plus 4c3 is 4 into 100 plus 4c4 is 1 into 1 to the power 1 is 1 itself. This gives us 1 followed by 8 zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, plus 4 followed by 6 zeros, plus 6 followed by 4 zeros, plus 400 plus 1. And when you add all these quantities, you'll end up getting 10400401. So this is the value of 101 to the power of 4. And finally, we have to evaluate 99 to the power of 5. Here we can write 99 as 100 minus 1. This implies 99 to the power of 5 is equal to 100 minus 1 whole raised to the power of 5. And now, by using binomial theorem, we can write 100 minus 1 whole raised to the power of 5 equals to 5c0 100 to the power 5 minus 5c1 100 to the power 4 into 1 plus 5c2 into 100 to the power 3 into 1 square minus 5c3 into 100 into 1 cube plus 5c4 into 100 into 1 raised to the power of 4 minus 5c5 into 1 raised to the power of 5. This is equal to 5c0 is 1 into 100 to the power of 5 is 10 raised to the power of 10 minus 5c1 is 5 into 100 to the power of 4 is 10 raised to the power of 8 plus 5c2 is 10 into 100 cube is 10 raised to the power of 6 minus 5c3 is 10 into 100 plus 5c4 is 5 into 100 minus 5c1 is 1 into 1 to the power of 5 is 1 itself. So this gives us 1 followed by 10 zeros, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, minus 5 followed by 8 zeros, plus 10 followed by 6 zeros, minus 10,000, plus 500, minus 1. And now when you do the arithmetic in this step, you'll get 950990049. This is the value for 99 raised to the power of 5. So this completes our solution.